This is the interface when you navigate to the USGS Earth Explorer. We are going to be downloading data from the Earth Explorer. It's quite easy to use once you have the hang of it. So there are various options for you here. You've got search criteria, the data sets that you can download, additional criteria, which means that you can filter on certain aspects of the data sets, and then your results viewer. When you first land on this page, you can upload a KML or a shapefile to focus on your area of interest. For example, I'm going to upload a shapefile now. So I'm going to navigate to my hard drive where it's stored. It's the footprint that I've created, and that is an area in Hatfield. So in the Pretoria area, as you can see on the screen there, this helps the Explorer, the USGS Data Explorer, to filter the available images for this area, so you only get those as a result when you do your search. So when you have a look at your data sets, it lists all the data sets that are available to you here. So I'm going to be downloading from the Landsat data sets, the various Landsat ones. So you expand Landsat, and then you would expand the Landsat collection to level 2 one, and you're interested in the Landsat 8 data. So just ensure that it's ticked for you there. This tells the interface that you're interested in only this product, so none of the other products will come up as an option for you to download. When you have selected the data sets that you want, the next step is to then create an additional filter on what you actually want within those data sets, the additional criteria. So once you click on the additional criteria, for example, you can switch between Sentinel-2 and Landsat 8. The products that you want to download or view will be listed under the data sets button. So go to Landsat 8 and then expand the date produced one. And I would be interested in everything from the beginning of 2000, from 2020. So I'd go to 2020 forward slash January, so 01 forward slash 01. So that would be the 1st of January 2020 up till today. So I'll go 2021 and I'll put in 09 and 10. And then when you click on results, this is when you will. That this interface starts searching for suitable images in your search area. So that red rectangle that you see on your screen. As you can see here, the latest tile that was collected is from the 31st of August 2021. It is in path 170 and row 078. And as you scroll through the list, you'll see that all of these are the same, path 170 and row 078. It's because your area of interest is actually quite small and happens to fall directly in one of these paths and rows. So the tiles cover this area perfectly. If you're interested to see in how big the actual tile is, the image collected from Landsat, click on the show footprint. As you zoom out, you'll see this is actually the area covered by that particular image. It's quite a large area. So, and as you can see, that red rectangle is still there, but it's such a small part within this bigger image. That's why all of these images are from the same path and the same row. The path and row, of course, refer to how the satellite crosses over that portion of the Earth in its orbit. You can also click on the image to find out additional information, the metadata. So here, all the information that is related to that image is given. For example, the full name, the scene identifier, when it was acquired. Again, the path and the row are indicated. Additional information about the position of the satellite above the surface of the Earth, used for geometric corrections and other corrections before you get the product. Then when it was taken during the day, the amount of cloud cover in the scene, so that's less than 1%, which you can expect in an image that was taken during winter in Gauteng, and additional information. So there's quite a lot of information for you there. For example, it is a coordinate reference system is given, the spatial extent on the Earth, the lat and the long are given as well, and so forth. If you want to download this image, You just simply say the download options button and you will get the options to download. Now, there are lots of options available to you. The Landsat 8 platform is a multispectral platform. It has more than one band that it collects in. For example, a radar-based one, then bands 1 through to 7. So this would be your red, green, blue, your near-infrareds, and so forth. It also collects information on aerosols. Here's band 10. If you want to read up on this, I suggest you actually search for Landsat 8 and go to the NASA website where it lists what all these different bands are. Or you can just download the entire scene. It's almost a gig big, but you can download it that way and then add the entire scene to your screen, to your map project, basically. Okay, so when the option comes up, just simply say save file and it will be downloaded to your desktop. And that you can then add to your GIS products or projects when you're ready to commence with analysis.